Hello and thanks for watching Proactive. I'm joined by Michael Edwards. He's the Chief Operating Officer at Black Swan Graphene. Michael, very good to meet you.
Stephen, great pleasure to be here. Thanks for having us.
You're welcome, Michael. So Michael, can you start by explaining Black Swan's unique position in the graphene business?
Sure. There are a number of ways of manufacturing graphene or the graphene type technology. Our technology is based on what they call top-down technology. So it's a high shear liquid phase mechanical exfoliation of 3D materials into 2D. It's a bit of a mouthful, I know, but specifically in our case, it's taking graphite, exfoliating it into graphene nanoplatelets. We're the exclusive license holder of Trinity College Dublin Professor Johnny Coleman's patent in this area. And that's been already granted in America, in Korea, China, and Europe. And furthermore, Black Swan developed our own process patents, where we use this core technology to develop unique processes. And in this area, we've got 14 global patents in the processing of graphite to graphene nanoplatelets using this liquid phase exfoliation. So we hold a pretty clear part in that.
What sectors are you focused on to grow your business, Michael?
Our key focus, because graphene has a number of different application areas, but our key focus is to work in the major bulk graphene areas of concrete and polymers, where there are real-world challenges to reduce CO2 emissions and where bulk graphene offers excellent cost-performance benefits as a filler. So to quantify this in concrete alone, for example, if you take 10% penetration of that concrete market, within 3 years, the nanoplatelet demand will be around about 100,000 tons of graphene nanoplatelets at just 0.01% loading. That effectively means 1 kilogram per 10 tons of concrete. And that creates huge demand for the bulk graphene nanoplatelets.
Have you any real-world applications today?
Well, we've spent a number of years working on this with our partners at the Graphene Engineering Innovation Center. The acronym is the GEIC, at the University of Manchester, where graphene was discovered. And we've delivered a number of customer-specific successes in this area, both in polymers, concrete, and in fact, in other areas such as coatings. Two of these applications demonstrate major significant benefits in different polymers, in abrasion resistance, in mobile phone handsets, for example, and in application areas that reduce the weight of certain polymers with low volumes of additive. We're seeing significant compressive and flexural strength, for example, in a partner's admixture in concrete, and significant anti-corrosive performance benefits in industrial coatings.
I mean, and can you provide samples to customers if they want to design using your product?
Sure. Our facility in the north of England provides a source of quality control production. Small production level orders are routinely being taken in tens of kilograms of product. And our capacity is far greater than this, up to 40 tons of aqueous dispersion today. We can produce samples in dispersion, in aqueous dispersion, and we can produce samples in powder.
And how do you guarantee consistency of supply, which seems to be a problem of the industry?
Well, having developed much of this early work with our partner at Thomas Swan, our processes and procedures are built on foundations of ISO standard quality operating procedures, deploying full quality control. So this has led to a 3-scale-up version already, and with our next phase imminent, the consistency of our product is core to our growth and actually core to the applications we've already worked with our partners at the GEIC. Our process is unique in that it can be licensed also to our supply chain partners. We've developed a deliberate policy to offer a work with expertise partnership, if you like, so that we can accelerate our time to market and allow channel development partners to embed our solution in their process. After all, they've got the expertise, not us. So for example, in concrete, if you take an example, there is not much point in expending so much energy in drying dispersion down to powder, only for that application to require water to to add to that as the first step. So we're in the business of trying to reduce CO2. Consequently, we can embed our process into each partner's supply chain to minimize wasteful energy and CO2 production.
Michael, that's been very illuminating. I hope you'll keep us updated as you keep on developing the business, but thank you for speaking with us today.
You're very welcome. Thanks for having me.
Michael Edwards is Chief Operating Officer at Black Swan Graphene.